Have you ever thought about starting your own BookTube channel? Well, today I'm going to give you 10 easy peasy steps to get you up and running right away. Hi everyone, I'm Lisa London, romance author over at Lisa London Books. First, let's just define what is a BookTube channel. It is simply a channel on YouTube where they talk about books. Now, it could be a group of people, it could be a single person, it could be partners. It doesn't really matter. They just love books, just like you know what a book blog is. Same thing, that's what a BookTube channel is. It's just on YouTube. So having said that, I have a list of 10 easy peasy steps. And so the first five are all about equipment and software. And the second five is all about content. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, the first thing is your camera. And I'm going to try to break this down into low, medium, high based on your budget. You can obviously use your phone, your tablet, your computer. That's what I started out with. And the quality I think looks just fine. And again, if you're not willing to take the time and energy to learn how to use a DSLR camera, then that's probably not a good investment of your money, despite how great the film may look anyway. The middle of the road after that, if you're going to invest some money, I would say is a vlogging camera. The great thing about vlogging cameras is they're light, they're portable, they have a flip screen so you can see what you're recording in real time. They have a built-in mic, so, and they just have a really high quality as well. Those will run you about $100 to $200. And then your third option is to use a DSLR, which is what I'm recording on. I have a Canon Rebel T7i. I also upgraded from the kit lens, and the kit just means what comes with it as standard stock. And I purchased a Sigma lens, which has a low f-stop. And because I have a low f-stop, I have a blurry background. So you'll see a lot of beauty bloggers use that. And I just think it looks pretty. That ran me about $1,500 for that combo. Now, I didn't start out with that. Like I said, I kind of just built up and I decided I really liked YouTube and I wanted to invest in those. The second thing is sound. I use a Blue Yeti mic. Again, your phone or your computer is going to have a built-in mic. Or if you really want to use kind of the gold standard, you could upgrade yourself to a shotgun mic from Rode. You could use a lapel mic. I prefer the Blue Yeti because I also do webinars, and so it's very versatile. I can plug it into the DSLR, or I can plug it into the computer and use it that way. The third thing is lighting. Now, obviously, sunlight is free, but if you live in a place, especially in the winter, that doesn't get a lot of sunlight and has a lot of overcast days, this will severely impact your ability to schedule your video recording and to be as efficient as you would like to be. I think a box set is a very inexpensive solution. Those are about $40. That's what I started out with. Right now, I use a Diva Light Ring. That cost me $80. It's not that expensive, and it's kind of the gold standard in what everybody uses. The fourth thing is your backdrop. So you'll notice in my older videos, my backdrop was whatever happened to me in the background. I didn't really put any effort into it, so it wasn't as pretty. You probably want a bookshelf. The fifth thing is your software. So it's great if you can record all of your video in one take and it's perfect and you can post it. Awesome. But for the rest of us, we probably have to edit, take a few takes, and cut some stuff in and out. If that is the case, or if you're like me, even if I record a perfect video, I like to put text inside my video. I think it helps. I like to put B-roll. B-roll is simply other things in the background, or it could be stock videos. And that to me just helps to make the video a little more interesting, and I enjoy doing that. So if you have a Mac, iMovie is free. I don't think there is anything for PC, but don't quote me on that. I'm not a PC user. If you're going to upgrade to the next level for video editing, I would use Filmora. It is a really easy to use, not very technical, helps you look amazing, and has really great flashy, fancy animations. And it has a lot of templates that you can go ahead and use. If you are moving up from that, you could use Final Draft or Adobe Premiere. I use Adobe Premiere. That's about $29.95 a month. And it does have a huge learning curve. It did take me a while to learn it. I have a free tutorial over on my channel. It's about 30 minutes long where I walk you through exactly how I edit a video from start to finish. So let's recap. These are the top five for equipment and software. We talked about your camera. We talked about sound. We talked about lighting. We talked about your backdrop and we talked about your software. So next, let's go ahead and talk about content, because you need some content to put out there. The first thing you need to do is decide the theme and style for your channel. So are you going to talk about mysteries? Are you going to talk about science fiction? Are you going to mix some other things in there? Like my friend Caitlin mixes movies where she does her reactions to them, or talks reactions to movies, or she talks about upcoming new releases. You can mix things around, talk about lifestyle. Maybe you like talking about baking or gardening or something else maybe related to that genre, and make your channel a little more interesting or help it stand out. The second thing that you need to think about is how often you're going to post. I would not post more than once a week, or maybe not even commit to anything if you're just not sure, because that week will go by so fast, you won't even believe it. Now, when I do a video, it takes me an hour to research the topic, another hour to record it, and another hour to edit it, and another hour to create the thumbnails and social media posts to advertise it. So I need to allocate in my sort of planning budget 4 hours for every video that I want to post. I commit to one video per week for my author channel, and then I commit to 3 videos a week for my planner channel. So I know that I need to dedicate that much time, and I build that into my schedule. The third thing to think about is your first video. So definitely do an about you video, 1 minute, maybe two, talk about what the channel's about, what they can expect from you, and how often you're going to post. And the second video I would do is a new to BookTube tag. So if you don't know what a tag is, it is simply usually a set of questions or criteria that everyone should do for that particular video. So if I have a new to BookTube tag, I'm answering 10 questions, and so is everybody else who says they're creating a new to BookTube tag. Is where are you going to find ideas? So the easiest place to find ideas is simply to look at other BookTuber channels. What I've done is I have a notebook, it's my YouTube schedule, and in the front I have a calendar, and I put all the videos in there that I want to do and the dates they're going to air. And then over here I have all of my ideas, and every time I have an idea, I carry this with me everywhere. I kind of write it down, and I keep everything in one place. Now, the other thing is, there are videos that are pretty much standard to BookTube. So when you hear about a BookTube channel, you're expecting a TBR, you're expecting book hauls, you're expecting BookTuber collaborations, maybe a readathon challenge, 24-hour reading challenge is a big one that has been popping up lately. There are also, you know, books that I loved, books that I want to return, books that, you know, so there's a ton of different sort of BookTuber subjects that people kind of rinse and repeat every month. And that's totally fine, because everyone's expecting that person to put their own unique spin on it and maybe talk about only that particular genre. So that's where they're coming to your channel. They're not necessarily coming for a TBR list. They're coming to you because they know that your TBR list are books that they really love and identify with. And that's why they're excited to find out what you're going to be reading this particular month. All right, so let's recap. The first thing was the niche and style for your channel. The second one is how frequently you're going to post. The third one is what's your first videos. The fourth one is where to find ideas. And the fifth one is the standards that are sort of tried and true for all BookTube channels. All right, I hope that was helpful. If you liked today's video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button below. Post new videos every week all about romance.